That was an amazing opening and title screen. Hello and welcome back, Pokefans, to Pokemon Shining Pearl. Last episode, we had received our starter Pokemon, Pippin the Piplup, as well as our Pokedex from Professor Rowan. This episode, let us explore Sanjim Town and then move on to Route 202. I will be trying to explore all the houses as well as talk to all the NPCs just to make sure that I don't miss any hidden items or any Pokeball items that are laying around. Well, let me talk to both the NPCs and see if they will give us any item. I'm having a hunch that this is Lucas's family and this is their house. Now let's go upstairs and see if anyone's up there. Okay. Let's go back down and go to the next house. Alright, there seems to be nothing really important in this house either. So let's go on ahead. On south of Sanjim Town. Now I do see an item over there. Let's see what it is. It's an antidote. Okay. I also really like the way the water has been designed. It's really, really pretty. Okay, let's just go into the Pokemart and then go into the Poke Center before we head out of this town. Currently, they are only selling the basic Pokeball Potion Antidote and Paralyze Heal. I will not be buying any potions or Pokeballs. I will be just buying an antidote and two paralyze heals over here. Then we can head out. I will also be talking to all the NPCs in the Pokemon Center. Finally, we are heading out to Route 202 and there is Lucas. Dash, do you know how to catch a Pokemon? So, I think this is going to be our tutorial for catching a Pokemon. and that's how it's done. Actually, I should have lowered the HP of the Pokemon. Yep, that's an important thing, to lower the Pokemon's HP as much as possible. If it's an healthier Pokemon, it is difficult to catch it. So that is true. Whenever we are going to catch a Pokemon, we need to make sure that the HP bar of the Pokemon is low, and also it will help if the Pokemon has some status like sleep, paralysis, poison, etc. Each route we will be able to find different Pokemons with different encounter rates. So I will be trying to put a table with the encounter Pokemons for the particular route as well as the rarity of their encounter. Now I will be trying and catching all the Pokemon that are available for Pokemon Shining Pearl. Now this is not necessary to fill the Pokedex, but I would just like to catch all the Pokemons that are available for Shining Pearl as a part of this playthrough. Now that I have caught the Shinx, let me go ahead and give it a name. And let me name the Shinx as Star. Now if you have any suggestions for the names of the Pokemon, you can always comment down below and I will pick it up from there. As I've also encountered a Starly, I will go ahead and catch this as well. And let me name the Starly as Stella. Before we move on, let me just check the health of Piplup. That's okay. I will be discussing the encounters for this route when we are usually in a trainer battle. As you can see, I have added the encounters for this route in the top right corner. So we have 4 Pokemons that we can find in this route. The first one is Bidoof, which is a normal type Pokemon. It is one of the most common Pokemon you will be finding in these games in almost all the routes. The second one is Starly. It is a normal and flying type Pokemon. It is one of the starter bird Pokemons that you get. A very good Pokemon if you want to have a strong flying type in the starting of the game. So these both are a common Pokemon. The third one that is going to be a common encounter in this route is going to be Shinx. It is a cute electric type Pokemon that also you can add it to your team. Of course, it's an early electric Pokemon. Finally, in the rarer side, you will be able to encounter Cricketot, which is a bug type Pokemon. Now, this is a generic bug Pokemon which will be evolving in an early stage. But for the sake of recording the data in the Pokedex, you can catch it in this route. If you had any difficulties finding this Pokemon in this route, you can also find this in route 203, so that's not an issue. Thank you. Moving on, let me just heal Piplup before the next battle and we can use a potion to heal it. That's a potion, and this is the only item we have in the route 202. So let's go ahead and go to Jubilee City. Hey Dash, how many Pokemon have you caught? Huh? I think you should catch some more. It might be more of a challenge raising a lot of Pokemon, but it's worth it. The more Pokemon you have, the happier you'll be. In Jubilee City, there's a trainer school. Check it out, Dash. Oh yeah, Barry went to the trainer school earlier. Okay, see you around. Work hard on your Pokédex. Great, now let's go ahead and explore the Jubilee City. Alright, no free items till now. So let's go upstairs. Alright, no free items in this house. So let's go ahead and go outside. Let me talk to all the NPCs who are standing outside and then also go to the Pokemon Center to heal my Pokemon. So this building seems to be the trainer school. Let's just explore the city before we go in there. Thank you. I don't think they'll let us to leave the city right now. Yeah, that was correct. So let me go back and go into the building. Great, this lady has given us a quick claw. Now quick claw is an held item. This will let your Pokemon actually move first occasionally when you're in a Pokemon battle. I will go ahead and give this item to Pippin. Alright, let's go outside and explore the rest of the city. Hi there, you should stick around. We are doing a Pokatch campaign soon. So the Pokatch campaign is how you will be getting the Pokemon Watch or Pokatch in short. We will be doing that as soon as we talk to Berry in the Pokemon Trainer School. Let's go towards the west side of the city. Now this guy over here, he is going to be giving us an old rod of his. Now let's move on to route 280 and see if we can go through there. Okay, for now we cannot go through this route. Let's try out the new old rod that we have got. This should be able to let us catch a Magikarp over here. You can also register the old rod and access it through the plus button. Well, let's try it again and see if we can catch a Magikarp this time. Oh well, I think third time's the charm. So let's try it again. Yes, there we go. Now we can go ahead and catch this Magikarp. Now let me go ahead and give it a name.
and that's done. Let's head back to Jubilee City and go into the Pokemon Trainer School. Yep, I hope that we have a lot of members subscribing to my channel as well. Guys, like and subscribe to my channel. Finally, let's go into the Pokemon Trainer School. And there's Berry. Let's go ahead and deliver his parcel. Alright, we obtained the town map. We will be able to access it through our menu. Now, if you go and talk to those two students who are standing over there, they will battle you. But I'm not gonna be doing that today. So let's go ahead and go outside. Let's go ahead and complete the Pokatch campaign first. Oh, are you a Pokemon trainer? But you don't have a Pokatch yet? Pokatch is short for Pokemon Watch. Oh my, you're a rare case indeed. You see, I invented and now manufacture Pokatch. Not only that, I am now conducting the Pokatch promotional campaign. All you have to do is find 3 clowns in Jubilee City. If you can find them, I'll give you your very own Pokatch. Great, let's go ahead and find the clowns. This is the first one. Hi, I'm a Pokatch campaign clown. Let's roll out my question. Does a Pokemon grow by defeating others and gaining experience? That is a yes. Ding ding. Absolutely correct. Pokemon grow stronger by defeating other Pokemon in battle. Some Pokemon even change into different Pokemon through a process known as evolution. Here you go, your Pokatch coupon. Alright, that's one of the 3 coupons. Let's go ahead and find the other 2 clowns. Alright, there's a second clown. Hi, I'm a Pokatch campaign clown. Let's roll out my question. Can a Pokemon hold an item? Yes. Ding ding, absolute correct answer. A Pokemon may hold a single item. Some items become effective as soon as they are held by a Pokemon. Berries are eaten by Pokemon as necessary during battle. Here you go, your Pokatch coupon. So that's going to be the coupon number 3. So we just need to find the clown for coupon number 2. And there's our last clown. Hi, I'm a Pokatch campaign clown. Let's roll out my question. Just like Pokemon, do the moves of a Pokemon also have types?
Yes.
Ding ding, you're absolutely correct.
If a Pokemon type matches the type of move it uses, that move is made more powerful.
Here you go, your Pokatch coupon.
This is the last coupon we needed. Let's go ahead and go back to the Pokatch campaign guy.
Okay, let me count your coupons. I'll pull out my Pokatch here and 1, 2, 3. Bravo! I say bravo. In return for these coupons, I'll present you with the Pokemon Watch, or Pokatch for short. So this is how we are going to get the Pokatch. Let's go ahead and open it. So we will have to be using the R button to access the Pokatch. The first screen that you see when you access the Pokatch is the timer. If you click on the button, you can go to the calculator. The next one is the step counter. If you click again, it will give you the Pokemons in your party and the health details. For now, this is all the apps you will be having in the Pokatch. But as you progress throughout the journey and get more gym badges, you will be able to come back to the Jubilee City and get more apps. Now let's go to the very last building that we did not explore till now in Jubilee City. This is the Pokatch company building, and this is where you will be able to come in later stage and get new apps for your Pokatch. I will go ahead and talk to all the NPCs in the building. Now just my curiosity, I'm just wondering if that vending machine is actually accessible for us. No. Okay, let's go back. Now we are able to go north of Jubilee City. But we do have Rock Smash Rocks over there, so we will only be able to access a small part of the 204 route. So I will make sure that I don't go ahead and battle all the trainers here. I will leave them for after the first gym. Alright. Since we have a new Pokemon over here, let me go ahead and catch it.
I really like this Badoo, so I will be going ahead and using this in my team for now. Let me go ahead and catch it. Great, now that I've got the Badoo, let me go ahead and name it as Rosa. Let's go back to the Pokemon Center. As we have explored the Sanjin Town, Route 202 and Jubilife City, I will be stopping this episode here. In the next episode, we can go to Auburg City and get our first badge. Thank you all for watching. Please like, share and subscribe this video. Bye!